make a motion that we open the public hearing for AP180004.
Second.
Have a second. A motion to second. All those in favor? Unanimous.
This request involves an appeal of an administrative decision of the Forsyth County Department of Planning and Community Development.
Mr. Bose, opening statement.
Opening statement. There was a stop work order number two, which was on January 29th, and Mr. Pruitt talked about that too. So this takes it into the state finally. And this is about MRPA. And they cited me with a stop work with MRPA, which this sign is still there on the gate. So my opening statement is that I never had to apply for the permit, and MRPA agrees with me, and I'll approve that. Thank you.
Paul.
Filed by Mommies Properties was decision issue stop work order without prior notice for pasture remediation at 3450 Brentwood Drive, coming decision that MRPA certificate and review was required for the work. Gentlemen, I think the testimony you'll see is that there was no indication to Mr. Brown at the time that the stop work order was issued as to what these four piles of dirt, with three more that were turned away and additional ones on the way, there was no indication provided as to what was going on. All we had was the transportation of dirt across the property, dumped on the property, more on the way. That's what the facts were known by Mr. Brown at the time when he was forced to apply the MRPA regulations and the associated rules. Get to those particular rules. MRPA, Metropolitan River Protection Act, says section this. Okay, and as Mr. Bose is saying, hey, now we're at the state. Yeah, I mean, and that was one of the reasons I wanted to keep these separate, because it is important to know what we are applying. And in this case, this is what we're applying. Section 12-5-444B says, it shall be unlawful within those areas regulated by the plan or any portion thereof, or any minute thereto, for any person to engage in any land disturbing activity in the corridor which will be incompatible or inconsistent with the plan. A proposed land or water use shall be deemed to not be in compliance unless and until the governing authority of the political subdivision issues a certificate for the proposed use pursuant to code section 12-5-445. And I think you find that would be CG 180008, which was the subject of the last appeal we heard. That would be the certificate that qualified to allow, to a permit to allow land disturbing activity on the property. But he didn't have that at the time. He hadn't applied for it at the time. And so Merkel was impacted and a violation occurred, and that's what we'll find out. There isn't a provision for if there's a substantial change. You still have to get a permit. If there's a substantial change from an existing permit, don't know if there's going to be any evidence of that. But it's not a, it doesn't get them out of the obligation. Oops. Okay. The Merkel Chattahoochee Corridor Plan, that's the applicable plan that they have to comply with. It says that the applicable plan shall apply to any plan, proposal, or action that involves any land disturbing activity as defined in the Metropolitan River Protection Act, including but not limited to scraping, plowing, clearing, dredging, grading, excavating, transporting, or filling of land or placement of any structure or impervious surface. I think we'll find that. And you've heard them, and the evidence is the same. It's the same dirt piles. It's the same trucks driving on and dumping the dirt. The same dirt sitting around. That creates the same violation. Here again, this is that last definition, it wasn't a definition but a requirement. Here's where it's actually defined in the state code. The state code includes the same language. You'll hear about, again, we're going to hear about exemptions. Now we're talking about the exemptions that come to the MRRPA requirements. And this is a state exemption. However, if we read it, the state exemption says, MRRPA shall not apply to the following uses: any land or water use, agricultural, animal husbandry, as defined in ordinances adopted by the governing authority. So the state is deferring on what constitutes agriculture to the county. So as much as this is a state statute, we're brought back to the county. And guess what the county's exemptions for agriculture will say? Specifically excluding the raising and or boarding of horses. So notwithstanding the fact that we've gone to MRRPA for the requirements, they're looking to the county to assess their exemptions. With respect to the enforcement, not only is the director authorized to enforce MRRPA, but this provision for MRRPA 12-5-452A says, if the governing authority determines that any person is violating any provision, the appropriate governing authority shall employ one or any combination of these methods. He didn't have the ability to just ignore what was going on there. He had a code. He had a land disturbing activity in front of him. He had the county ordinance that said what the exemption was. The exemption didn't apply. It expressly excludes the horse activities. Therefore, he had to do something. He issued a stop work order well within his authority, well within his ability to do so, and his discretion to do so, certainly not clearly erroneous. And at that point in time, what we get to do, we get a little bit of testimony with that. Again, this is pretty cut in the right face.
So, everything Mr. Paul said is good, except it applies for more than 1 acre. Bear that in mind. Now, like you said, finally we are to the state, and then.
I mean, I object to that in terms of if it's intended as evidence. I object to the statement.
It's in the reason. So.
Okay.
So, appeal application, you know what, this will be really good. Could you please?
Read it. Have you shown?
Yeah, you've seen everything I'm showing you.
Are you introducing this?
Sure, topic? Yes, everything I'm giving you, I want to introduce.
Okay.
That's the application.
What is it? If it's the application in this case?
Yeah.
It's land development permit flat application.
I just
flat it. Application or the appeal in this case?
Just show it to him again. I just showed you this.
It should be. I'd like to withhold my objection until I hear some evidence as to what its relevance is. It's a different application, so I don't know what the relevance is.
The relevance is, this is what I had to do because of the MRPA application as well as part of the whole application process for permitting where this ties in with my question that I asked MRPA. I did not bother with the county anymore. I went straight to MRPA and I showed them this. So please.
This is a state application?
This is our Forsyth County application.
Forsyth?
Yeah. Please publish that.
I'll admit it over.
Publish it.
Can I cannot see it one more time before it goes. I have no ability to cross-examine that person.
I will testify as to what my communication was, and I'm authenticating the email, and they could have brought Adam Hazel into the witness, that they gave me the name.
But you can't testify to what somebody from MRPA told you.
I'm not testifying, I'm presenting evidence.
Were you presenting an email from that person?
Communication with me.
Is it an email to you?
Yes, me and him. An email is presented as evidence with one party authenticating it. I'll swear and authenticate this as evidence.
If the purpose is to get the testimony in of Mr. whoever it is, Adam somebody's opinion, then it still is subject to the hearsay exception, or to a hearsay objection.
No, it's not.
It depends what the purpose of his offering. Is he offering to get what the comments were from MRPA?
Why are you offering?
Okay, so the county is telling me, giving me a stop work order, and they gave me a name, Adam Hazel. Who's Adam Hazel? I did not know. I had to track him down at Gainesville office. And he is the person that the county sends all the applications to. Actually, we can put Mr. Brown on witness whether they deal with Mr. Adam Hazel or not at his office.
Let's deal with this issue.
No, he will authenticate that. Are you familiar with Mr. Adam Hazel,
sir? Whoa.
Oh, I'm sorry.
If you want to call Mr. Brown as a witness, you can, but you don't. You can't just start
asking
questions.
Yes.
So, are you? What do you want to do?
That's why I'm asking you. Whether you want to know that the name Adam Hazel really exists and he is with Murpa.
Let me see the document.
Sure. You want to see them again?
Market B2.
Thank you, Honor. Okay. So, this is an email exchange between myself and Mr. Adam Hazel. Adam Hazel works for, he's the planning director, Georgia Mountains Regional Commission. And I
object to the testimony that that's what he is. I acknowledge that that's what the email says.
Go ahead.
So I communicated with him because the county gave me his name. I send in the entire piece of what I was doing there, and I want to short circuit this and just give you this one piece here, which is, could you just put this
on this? What are you doing?
Oh, just putting it publishing. This is the front page. And these are all pictures. I don't want to go through all of them, but I want them in evidence. He's seen it already. They are all
what
pretty much.
What is his position?
Oh, any objection?
Tell me what you want to do.
To my pictures? These are the pictures that I shared with Mr. Hazel. And these are the same pictures you already have in evidence.
Well, they're not the same pictures I have in evidence. Tell me what you purport. What are these pictures?
These are pictures of the farm.
Did you take them?
And yes, I took all of them.
When did you take all of them?
These were with the original application, so
month. Put this on the record and then.
Okay. Have you published? We'll finish that first. Okay, so please focus on this one. This is like a 5-6 page email, and look where it says, the next page tells exactly what the pasture plan is. He said, I did not hear back from somebody else, but I feel comfortable with my assessment. I'm not sure you even need a permit. This is coming from the gentleman that the county sends the paper to.
I'm just going to renew my objection. I have no way of saying what he's not sure about and how sure he is, and that's the basis of why we have a hearsay objection. Is
also, I think you need to go ahead and read the next sentence.
Yeah, go ahead.
I cannot speak for Forsyth County and recommend you get the confirmation as to why you would need a permit. So did you do that?
Yeah, I did that. And that's where we were stuck. So basically, if you go outside the county, they, for him to evaluate, he will only start with that part where if they ask me to ask him, I ask him and he said no, but the county still insists on it. And that's the entire point I'm trying to make with this appeal.
He said he cannot speak for Forsyth County.
Correct.
And Rick, but he says he's not. You get confirmation for what you want to do, basically, as to why you need a permit.
That's right.
And that's what you're disputing, is why you need a permit. But this is not confirmation from him that says you don't need a permit.
Correct. That's the whole point.
No. You misunderstood what I said.
Okay, what did
he say? He's not saying that you don't need a permit. He's saying he doesn't know.
Right. Why I need a permit? For point three.
No. He's saying he doesn't know whether or not you need a permit.
Okay.
We'll go through the whole thing then. Could you go to the next page, please?
Would you just want to read the whole email?
Whatever.
Then it'll become easy, it'll become clearer. You see the whole thread of the email. Then you'll understand why he's saying what he's saying in context. Okay, I can't read it. So, y'all read it, and he explains what the MRPA law is and the MRPA OCGA. That's the entire application.
You're staying.
Okay, good. I asked him that.
His second paragraph.
Yes.
Please note, I have not confirmed whether or not your proposal requires a Forsyth County permit.
Correct.
So you are advised to confirm with their development department if any particular permits or conditions are applicable in this case.
Correct. So but not for something that is less than
1.0.
He doesn't say that.
Yeah. See, that's the point. Go ahead. Just go to the cave, keep flipping a few more pages.
Now we're getting to older
stuff.
We're going back in time now.
Back in time, as in?
Well, now we're back to the 12th, I think, right, other from the 16th.
Yeah.
Correct. The MRPA order was in February, end of January 29th.
So you sent this email to this guy.
Yes.
And you asked him.
That's what the county asked me to do.
And he sent you back to the county to ask them.
No. What he's saying is that the county, if the county has a permit with a package for MRPA, I will see it, but for what you're asking for, you don't need a permit. And that's the context of the whole email.
That's not what he said.
Not what he said.
That's exactly what he said.
No, that isn't. He said
I would refer you back to the county. He's saying the county has the final word.
Right. Next page. Just go through a few more pages there. It's sort of important to get the context of this whole thing. See, that's what I showed him. So, what I showed him is what the area that we were going to rehab, and he has this ability to see whether it falls in his streams and buffers and all that stuff. So he's saying, I'm okay with it. I even spoke to him. So, but I won't talk about that. It's hearsay, right? But this is what he says. He says, yeah, I'm not sure you don't. He's saying, I'm not sure you don't. Check. Not the way you're interpreting it.
He's saying, this is what he says.
I'm sorry?
In both emails, he tells you to go to the county and see what the county says about your piece of property.
Right. Punting it back to the county, where the county sent me to him. And that's the whole plan I gave him in this. Any more questions about this one? Okay. So, and OCGA 12-5440 MRPA Act, because this is a MRPA citation. So, I have...
stipulate to the OCGA, I don't know whether he's got it correct, but it, the law is what the law is.
Yes. Question, Mr. Bose.
Yes, sir.
Why did they, the county feel compelled to issue a second stop work order when there was already one that was still in effect?
And that's what I'm appealing. I don't know. There's no need
to.
They
never gave you any explanation on why you got a second stop.
No. It's just, it just came.
I'm sorry, I'm muted.
It was plastered on the thingy. I mean, there's no work going on, no nothing going on. And they put that other notice, you know, on the second one. So.
Yeah, I went out there. I couldn't get past the gate. I didn't crawl through the gate.
Oh, okay. Okay. These are a couple of pictures I took. I told Mr. Paul.
Whoa, stop. You have to go through the procedure. Are you are you introducing those? Or are you objecting
to it? I told him
Are you testifying you took all those pictures?
Yes.
All those pictures of the property?
Yes.
Because I haven't seen that last one I just put up.
Meanwhile, I have this. Your OCGA 12-5-451 and UDC Chapter 7 for LDV.
Stop just a minute. B3 is admitted. These are the collection of your photographs. What is your next exhibit?
Next exhibit is 12-5-440.
Is that a code section?
Yes.
All right. B4, I'll admit that.
I'm assuming it's current. I assume we're...
Yes,
2018.
And the next one is 12-5-451. This is the MRPA Georgia Regional, MRPA Review Act.
Wait.
I think he needs to know what it is. Some of it, there's more to this than just this MRPA Act. I don't know if he realizes
MRPA.
That.
Sorry?
Is that a current copy of the act?
I think it's got the Georgia Mountains version?
Yeah,
I mean, it's got the plan, and it's more than just the act. I mean, I don't know if he realizes that.
And this is the Forsyth Ordinance, Chapter 7. And this is your Conservation of Natural Resources, 12-17-1.
To 12-7. Again, this is a state code. County has adopted its own Soil and Erosion Sedimentation Act. I acknowledge its existence and that it exists. I refute its applicability in this situation. And I don't know that if we're offering it as evidence and the board is considering state code evidence, then I would object to its admission as being irrelevant. To the extent it's just an acknowledgement of what the state code says, I acknowledge it.
Will this, his appeal relate to that law in any way?
Not in my opinion. The MRPA Act, that's not the MRPA Act, and the MRPA Act incorporates the local governing authorities' definitions of agriculture. So they're not relevant.
Okay.
But it's got the Georgia sedimentation and erosion.
It's also 3/20/2011. I'm going to deny admission of this. I'll admit the others. It's going to be the.
Which one are you denying, sir?
The 2011 copy of the state law.
On 12/7/1?
Is that what it is?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, as per 12/7/1, I mean, that's the latest one, so it still governs. And the exemptions are very clear. Less than 1 acre, you don't need any permit. Agriculture. Exemptions are very clear and then. Hence, he's objecting. So that's very relevant to the case. And it is state waters.
Well, you can argue state. What the law is without introducing copies of the law. So
okay.
You're free to do that.
I mean, this is what I know. At least it's an evidence. Okay. So we, and the application itself.
That's the application in this particular appeal. Okay, no objection.
That is the application, right?
Okay, VA is a copy of the application.
Correct.
So for Frickey, if you scan it, if you want to see it.
Okay, so.
Well, lips.
May I continue? Back to that less than 1 acre and having being so far away from stream buffers, what I did not fall in the purview of applying MRPA as a tool to do more stop work permit. So not only did I have that one, I had the two, there's nothing I could do. There's no breathing space there at all. That's why they said it needs to be taken out. So it got took out. It's just, no matter what I did, there was a no-win situation. It was always a lose-lose situation. But MRPA doesn't apply in this case. Thank you, Mr. Paul.
Let's roll.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. Thank you. I see you, sir.
Mr. Bose?
Yes, sir.
Aside from what, and
oh,
I get that email. Mr. Adam, I forgot his last name.
That's it.
Aside from your email from email chain from Adam Hazel, what other evidence do you have that you're anyhow anyway exempt from MRPA obligations?
Oh. Yes, like I mentioned before, going back to your OCGA 12/7/1, I'm exempted for being less than 1 acre.
Okay, you understand that the county has adopted its own Soil and Sedimentation Act, does not follow the state's. It does not follow precisely the state's Soil and Sedimentation Act, correct?
Correct. And
okay,
that is your Chapter 7, and even that complies with my not needing a pump for doing what I do. Did you introduce 73? I mean, Chapter 7?
Chapter 7 is with the whole UDC.
It is
the entire UDC is in.
In?
The entire Ordinance 73 is in.
Okay,
and you acknowledge that Mr. Hazel, as indicated by the MERPA Act pointed you back to the county for its conclusions as to whether or not a permit would be required?
Well, no, that's not what he said.
He said, basically,
He said what's in the email, right?
I'm sorry?
He said what's in the email, right?
Right.
And I don't have anything else to ask, right? I have to rely on what this says.
Sure.
And that's the only evidence you've got here tonight as to what Adam...
Except what I spoke to him, too.
Point to the 1 acre minimum requirement exemption under MERPA.
Pardon? What?
MERPA's 1 acre minimum exception.
MERPA's 1 acre minimum exception. That's in the 1988 law. Oh, they will not rule on whether it's less than 1 acre or more than 1 acre. Because that what his point is that when it's less than 1 acre, they never get application, so therefore you don't need to apply for it. So no. I'm not sure where exactly it is sitting in there. I have not looked at whether they have an exemption for less than 1 acre. I'm sorry.
Okay. If we look at OCGA 12-5-451, which is the exemption section for MERPA, says this part shall not apply to the following uses. That's these. Yeah, I don't know if we want to use your exhibit or mine. I've got mine highlighted.
No.
If you want to get. Where's the 1 acre?
Well, that's what I'm trying to tell you. It's not that not they have a requirement. It's that they never see one if it's less than 1 acre because you don't need to apply.
They never see one is the extent of it. But you don't have...
He said he never evaluates anything less than 1 acre because you have exemptions and you don't need to apply for that permit.
But you have no idea, and he didn't include why that is.
No, that's why the county sent me to the MERPA guy. That's why they gave me his name.
So they're saying the county...
Yes.
I'll have any additional questions, I suppose.
All right. Okay.
Does that conclude your case? Those?
Yes.
Okay. Frickey, anything on behalf of the county? Evidence or any witnesses?
Can't call Tom Brown.
Without verifying compliance with MERPA. MERPA is not a topic they are concerned concerned about. So I talked to staff in the engineering department, and they said there's a potential their stop work could be lifted without ever having the applicant submit for a land disturbance permit. Had the applicant submitted for the land disturbance permit, my staff were already notified to make sure they would review that land disturbance permit for permit compliance. But the engineering department identified that if the site was stabilized, there was a possibility they would lift their stop work without ever requiring a permit be submitted, and then I would not have a way to verify compliance with MRPA. So we issued the second stop work notice and referenced, you can see on it, it's referencing MRPA.
And just to be clear, the specific work on the property that triggered your conclusion that you needed to issue stop work order was what?
It was the dump trucks of dirt being stockpiled on the property.
That's all the questions that I have, Mr. Brown.
Hey, Mr. Brown, how are you?
Fine.
Good. So, again, going back to the stockpile, how did you know stockpiling happened there?
Well, all I knew very little at that point was that it was, I think it's fair to say, I knew we had a report from Doug Briggs that multiple dump trucks had brought dirt out of the property. Mm-hmm. That's all I knew.
And who told you what exactly was being done there? Did anybody tell you?
No.
So it was more preventive for the MRPA stop order?
It was a concern that someone bringing multiple dump trucks of dirt out of their property, there's a very high likelihood they are not going to be in compliance with MRPA. So to put a stop work to say, can't have this go on until we verify that it is in compliance with MRPA.
Are you familiar with the Western properties in Forsyth County?
To what extent?
Do you know any?
I'm familiar with yours.
Yes. Other than mine, do you know other equestrian properties?
We do have other equestrian properties in the county, yes.
Have you been to one?
No, man, I'm not sure I've been to yours either.
Did you get any opinion, expert opinion or otherwise, about what we do on the property?
No, we had a site visit scheduled with you. Mm-hmm. I think we could have worked out any of those issues and canceled it. And then through the code enforcement department.
You had a site visit scheduled with me? What date was that?
It was January 4th. You had a site visit with the, if it was Doug Briggs or Steve Zaring, someone in code enforcement.
Oh, that was after the stop work order was issued.
After the engineering department stop work.
Correct.
Prior
Not
to.
Not before.
After the first stop work.
Right.
And before the second, we had a meeting scheduled that was canceled.
Okay. Okay. Do you know that I did speak to them? I did speak to the inspectors. Did you speak to Mr. Pruitt?
No.
Did you speak to Mr. Bridges?
Doug Briggs, yes.
Briggs, sorry. My apologies. And so, did he tell you what I was doing?
It was the day that engineering issued their stop work order.
Yes.
Yes, he did call me. He told me what you were doing was bringing truckloads of dirt onto the property. Mm-hmm.
What was the purpose of the dirt?
You didn't hear that.
Oh. Okay, so you didn't know what you were going to do with it.
I agree. I did not know what you were going to do with it.
Okay. Have you ever come across anybody in the county ever doing topsoil application for their pasture, be it agriculture, bovine, equine, swine, anything?
I have not. Now, that's not to say that's not taking place. Okay. And it's also not to say that had we had discussions on that topic, I don't know what the result would have been. It's possible I would have lifted the stop order, but we didn't have those discussions. And the information I have today, after sitting through this meeting, is not the information I had when I issued the stop order. The information I have when I issued the stop order was just that multiple dump trucks of dirt were arriving on the property.
Okay. Do you have any idea about how a horse farm is run?
I have no experience in running a horse farm.
No. Have you researched it after this case? After all these evidence started?
No.
No. Okay. Does any of the process or pain, I would say, I went through, has it affected anything that y'all are going to change to make it simpler for something that's less than 1 acre?
There's no, I don't have any changes in the works, no.
Is there any
I don't draft or adopt the order. I don't adopt the ordinances that the county, I enforce the ordinances, I apply the ordinances, I don't adopt them.
Okay. So, is there any alternative process to do what I was doing for years on the books?
Well, I'll return to this theme of I've heard a lot about your operations today at this meeting. I haven't had that information before. I haven't discussed that information with Adam Hazell at Georgia Mountains, the Regional Development Center. And is it possible that we could come to a determination one day that certain activity is would not require a permit, or certain permit activity would not require compliance with MRSPA. But that's possible. All I know is we had a report for dump trucks of dirt coming in. We didn't have any justification for why, and we put a stop work on the property until we could figure it out.
Okay. So now, after hearing all this, you understand that the justification was given, right?
I never received justification.
Yeah, you never received one. Do you understand at least it was presented to the people that I was dealing with?
I'll object to the sentence. That was never in any of the testimony we had here tonight.
He can ask that question, the witness can answer.
I understand you were telling me you made your case to those people.
Correct. Thank you. And how long have you been at this director job?
6 or 7 years.
And in these 6, 7 years, how many applications have you seen for somebody who has to topsoil for grass?
I'm not aware of any.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Your staff is really good.
Thank you.
Can you redirect?
No regret. And can rest with that? Thank you.
All right. Anyway, any member of the public desire to speak in favor of or against the application?
Oh, one more. Closing.
One more. Closing argument.
One more. I'll wave.
Oops. Gentlemen, this is probably the most layered of the cases we've had this evening, in that it both asks you to look specifically what the request to appeal was, and that was whether the stop work order was appropriately entered. That calls into question your role Brown's decision with the information that he had as to whether the stop work order should have been entered. Again, it also brings into question a repeated thing which just does not seem to be thinking that an exemption in one place does not mean it's an exemption in another place, and we have to look at what the county's enforcing. Granted, we're looking at MRPA, but MRPA incorporates the county's definition by MRPA's own terms, a state code, it defers to the county definition of agricultural uses. Mr. Hazel, the most Mr. Bose could bring to you would, when I didn't get a chance to get it clarified, but it seemed clear, Mr. Hazel certainly seemed to understand that it was a county, that the county was responsible for making that determination whether it needed a permit. We've shown you that that exemption didn't apply, that there was a permit required. Now, we again have to go back to this board requirements under the United Unified Development Code as to what its obligation are. It's not to reweigh the evidence as if it were the first time looking at it. It's to say, what did Mr. Brown know? What was his decision appropriate? I think we've established that, notwithstanding however many times Mr. Bose has suggested subsequently, and we don't really have evidence to that other than saying that he said that without testifying to where that was actually said, that it was being used for topsoil, he had the opportunity to make that presentation, and we're here because that didn't happen. I mean, he decided to file appeals and then has not been able to put something before us until even now. And even then, the testimony, if you recall, this was incorporated into this sitting. If you go back hours ago, I apologize for that, but you did hear Mr. Briggs testify that the John Harris, who was on site at the time, indicated that the dump trucks were there to store dirt. This topsoil thing was not the information that was presented at the time. Whether or not it's true now, I don't know, but that was not the information that was provided to the county. Not only was no information provided, actually, almost the opposite of what we were told. And of course, the so-called topsoil, which did the county not say you have to move that pile of topsoil, they said don't move it. Supposedly topsoil to be dressed on the field it's sitting in was removed. That just doesn't add up to it was going to be used for topsoil. If you're going to use the topsoil, it's already there. All you have to do is push it. It just doesn't add up. I think the board, under the standard of proof that the applicant is required to present, has failed completely to establish that the director's decision to issue a stop work order was inappropriate at all. It certainly wasn't clearly erroneous, and this board should affirm the county's decision. Thank you very much.
I'm again confused as to, I have testified exactly what they told me to do. I even asked Mr. Pruitt, sure, he said no, but I've spoken to all of them at various times, and they said take it out, so it got taken out. But that is not part of what this particular appeal is about. And this is purely whether MRPA stop order should have been issued. Again, we go back to Mr. Brown testified in 6-7 years he's been the director, he's never seen an application for 0.3 acres for permitting to put topsoil. It's not happened. And this topsoil has been a practice that we have done for a long time. And you've heard enough about it, and I will put it in emails. So, saying that that is not what it was for is completely wrong. It's mischaracterized what the testimony is. And as per Georgia law and our own UDC, I do not need to get a permit for less than an acre. And yes, thank you.
Public hearing. The board is free to ask questions and move to close the public hearing and make a decision.
Questions, gentlemen, before I close the public hearing, before we close it? I make a motion that we close the public hearing for AP180004. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Not a second. All those in favor? Okay, we've heard a lot of evidence, testimony, a lot of which is kind of repetitive, but still applicable. Any discussion amongst the board at this point? Is there a motion?
Mr. Chairman, I would like to move that the board affirm the county's decision for appeal application AP180004.
Have a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion at this point? No discussion. All those in favor? Moving right along. Slowly moving.